Europe. And I remember in 1975, the exhibition was held in Milan, and my company was the first Indian company to take part in that exhibition. Today, the same exhibition, I think at least more than 200 Indian companies are taking part. Coming back to India, in 1980, the first exhibition was held where the current Leelavati Hospital is standing today. That was open ground in those days, and we had put up tents, virtually tents, to exhibit the machinery. And of course, it was a much smaller exhibition that time. But all the same, it did draw a lot of attention from the machinery manufacturers. And subsequently, we shifted to NESCO, which was, in those days, NESCO had a factory there making textile machinery, which they had closed down, and they did not know what to do with the big empty hall. It was India ITME who ventured to prepare the halls and make the difference, and they have come a long way today. Except for one exhibition in 2008, we ventured out to Bangalore, where they have a new exhibition center. All the other exhibitions have been held in NESCO. NESCO has now decided to venture into other businesses, like putting a 5-star hotel, and they already built a couple of buildings for IT industry. So we are forced this time, our next exhibition will be in Noida, where a brand new center has come up. So with these few words, I invite your questions whenever you are ready, I suppose, and I pass the mic to my colleague, Mr. Narendra Shah.
Mr. Shah, would you like to add to
it
that how the accessories, how we have come as a country so far in accessories manufacturing?
To be aware, before we started all this in 1980s, most of the items were imported here. There was no local industry as such. And it has taken quite a number of years to develop that industry. And this exhibition, our organization, which is now 40 years old or more, the exhibition in this, participation in this exhibition and the international symbol of that has helped industry greatly and the textile industry also together. Our growth is only dependent on textile industry because we are helping the textile industry. And maybe a good number of you may not be familiar with textile industry, but the textile is our inherent, everybody uses textiles. So it is worthwhile knowing it. And when you, as Seema has already invited you, do come and see the exhibition. They are all working machinery. And you can see how the textiles are produced, how your designs are happened, and how various finishes are given to the industry and the finish, and it will be very interesting for them to do this thing. We have been involved in this industry, so it is nothing new for us, but basically it is a very, very interesting. I invite you all to come and see the exhibition during the at Goregaon, and we will be very glad to have you all there. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Narendra Shah. For all of us here, I just would like to share something that what we do as a nation, what we do as an organization, which is an industry body. So it belongs to all of us, you know. I mean, from the textile industry, from the textile machinery industry. So it is a national property or whatever the organization. We should be very proud that we as a single country is organizing such an international level, attracting international participation and bringing, as it was mentioned, the largest textile engineering exhibition is held in Europe, and 7-8 countries come together for that. 12.
All
so,
the
yeah, all of them come together to create and they jointly organize that exhibition. And we, India, as one developing country, you know, where we are not anywhere, we compete and our exhibition is a global event which is marked in every textile industry businessman's diary. They ensure that they participate. So I think collectively all of us should be very proud. And some women power there.
Certainly, certainly.
Yeah. Continuing with this thought, I would also like to share that today we claim that we are the world's second largest textile industry, China being the largest. Mr. Latia here is from Stanford and he studies a lot of comparative textile industry from various countries. Sir, can you throw some light on how we should go forward in, you know, yeah, tough question. You can.
Very tough. Good afternoon, everyone. All the best for 2019. Before I answer that question, a little bit more on GTTS. Our signature exhibition is the India Textile Machinery Exhibition, which is a very large exhibition spanning almost 6 days, 7 days, etc. And we have about something like 1,500-1,600 exhibitors. It's very expensive for a lot of the smaller companies to exhibit their wares and participate. And it is held every 4 years. So we thought in between, if you have a smaller exhibition where a smaller manufacturers can exhibit and show their wares at a lower cost. So GTTS has been targeted to the small and medium Indian textile engineering manufacturers who are there, who can participate, come, show their products and see what their competitors are offering, because this is an open platform and we allow even the international companies to participate. They also interact with not just their local buyers, Indian whom they are, you know, from the local clusters or things like that, but is to see that there is a market outside India also which is very large. So this was the thought behind having GTTS, you know, very small focused exhibition showing the latest technology. This is a big help. My elders here, Narendra Bhai and Mr. Demla, were pioneers in setting up the large international textile machinery exhibition with a view to not just help our textile engineering industry but our user industry, the textiles industry. Because, you know, to send somebody outside India is very, very expensive, and in those days you needed permits and foreign, you had to apply for, you know, foreign exchange and things like that, which even I did when I joined my business 30 years ago. And the Indian technicians, the people who were operating the machines, the junior level people, they could not see what was available outside. And unfortunately, our educational institutes in those days did not have the modern machinery and modern technology. So this was a big step and leap forward. 40 years ago, most of you, we did not have cell phones, we did not have international dialing, you had to book a call, you know, telephone line was a problem. And in those days, you know, to think that we can bring everybody, including the foreign exhibitors here, so that our Indian industry could benefit. India Igneous Society is a venture of the textile machinery and accessories manufacturing sector. We are a non-profit and we are not a professional, exhibitor like those who are coming up now. Coming back to India, China, I think, China is the 800-pound gorilla. They are going to be number one. They have exports of almost 8 to 10 times our size. So there's no comparison. But because of certain reasons, China is leaving many areas of business which are being opened up for India. One of the things that has happened about a decade ago when the MFA agreement was dismantled, at which time, you know, today now the buyers, etc., everybody look to buy garments. And this is one of our areas and focus areas for us. garment making machinery, where we have not been very strong for both our user industry in terms of garmenting and Indian manufacturers, textile engineering, making garmenting machinery. So this is one area that is focused for us, and this is where India can easily catch up, because we have a large pool of labor. And a couple of years ago, government of India also came out with a liberalized policy for new garment making units, higher subsidy, relaxation from some of the labor laws for newer industry. I think this is what needs to be done more for India to capture the world market. Another thing that we need to do as a country is focus on Make in India as a brand and develop brands for international listing. There are a few brands who are known, but we need to have more of these in the world. In terms of engineering and industry, India makes the full spectrum of machines. We have the raw materials in terms of the fiber, cotton, jute, silk. In fact, we are blessed that India has the largest variety of fibers available, including synthetics. And we have the machinery making to convert it into the final product. So as Prime Minister always says, from farm to foreign, the five F's that he says, we have everything. We only need to concentrate more on getting to foreign for this thing. And that way we will be very helped with